Hey, Robin here from Post Professionals. Here, just one chapter from one of my longer videos for easier access. But if you prefer to watch the whole thing in one go, you can find the link either up here or down in the description. Either way, I hope you enjoy, and if you do and it was helpful, maybe do me a solid and give me a thumbs up, or even smash the old subscription button, which really helps the channel. Thanks, and now this. And then there's the new copy to library command. With this, you could easily create a proxy-only copy of a library as well, but also use this to make an archival version of your library that only contains the media you want to keep, or for simply copying one library to another. To do this, I simply right-click the library I want to copy, and here, midway down, you'll find the new copy to library command. By the way, as you can see, you can also initiate the consolidate command just below it for both media and motion content, so one doesn't necessarily have to go to the library's information inspector. Going back to the copy to library command, we see that we get a flyout menu with options. At the top, I can choose to copy this library to any of the other currently open libraries. Selecting one opens the copy library window. Here I can choose what to include when copying. Whether I want to include the media and which of the three categories I want to include, be it original, optimized, and or proxy. Under media destination, I'm automatically shown the destination that is currently set for the receiving library. So I can have the media either copied there, change it to the receiving library itself, or even choose an all new location for what's about to be copied. For example, my wannabe server. I can also decide whether any media that may be stored outside of the library to be copied is also copied to the media destination I've chosen above, or is simply left where it is. And any changes I make also changes the storage location setting for the library that I'm copying to. Then I can also choose to copy the library without the media. Selecting this deactivates all the previous options below, since they've effectively become irrelevant. We're also told that using this option will have the clips appear as missing in the new library. I'll choose this and click OK. Back in the library sidebar, looking in the library that I chose to copy to, we can see the copied library's event or events have now been copied. And as we were told, selecting it shows all of the media as offline. At first, I actually had to think about when and how this could be useful. Then I thought, this is actually a nice option for when you want to exchange an entire library with somebody else that has copies of or access to the same footage, for example. So with this, you get the smallest possible library and simply need to reconnect the media at the other end. Something that I've in fact done many times before with colleagues I collaborate with that live in other countries. So this is something I've had to manually create, copy, etc. until now, but now it's only a few simple clicks away. Then there's one additional option that ties into both the exchange of libraries as I described, as well as an even simpler way of creating a proxy-only library. That's assuming that copying, and therefore effectively duplicating existing media, which means creating more data as opposed to just moving existing media, as I showed previously, isn't an issue or concern. Or, as I just mentioned, this could be used for creating a library with the least amount of data for archival purposes, for example. For all of the above, I just right-click the library again, return to the Copy Library submenu, and this time can select New Library at the bottom. With this, I'm first creating a new empty library for which I get a dialog box for naming it and selecting where to save it. I'll just name it DRV Archive and save it wherever I like. Then, just as before, select all the options I need. I can include original media for archival, or maybe redundancy, or just proxy media for the sake of size, for portability, or even just performance. By the way, this same window now also appears when simply dragging a library onto another, or even just dragging a project from one event to another. The latter meaning I'm only copying media used in that project, not the entire library. So this would be a perfect solution for anyone wanting to only archive the media that they actually used in any given project, leaving everything else behind. So yet another very cool and helpful addition to Final Cut's media management abilities.
So was that helpful? Again, if so, then maybe give me a quick thumbs up, or even hit the subscription button and little bell to help the channel, which allows me to continue to produce these free tutorials and so you don't miss future ones. For that, a huge thank you in advance, and I hope to see you in the next one, or maybe in one of these videos that YouTube thinks you need to have seen as well. Either way, until then, take care.